with Stiggy TV, we have today T-Man the Tyler. What it do, bro?
What it do, bro? What it do?
Appreciate you joining Stiggy TV today, man.
Definitely.
First of all, go and give the people your social media so they can find you, you know.
Well, Snapchat, T-Man the Tyler, no spaces, MANDATYLER. Instagram, T-Man3334. Also, T-Man and Tyler. You can look me up on T-Man and Tyler. Pretty much anything. Facebook, YouTube, Spotify, iTunes. Pretty much all your platforms. Look me up, T-Man and Tyler.
And what made you want to start rapping?
For real, I kind of just liked my sound, the sound of me on the beat. I used to write poems, so.
Oh, you did poetry?
Yeah, it was kind of easy to. You know what I'm saying? Put the word
transfer it,
transfer it over to a beat, and then I kind of started getting good at it, so I stuck with it. That's all pretty much.
All right, now what made you want to do poetry, and then lead on into rap?
My mama and my brother, my big brother, James Tyler, they were doing poems. I pretty much wanted to just do. I was doing stuff when I was little.
Yeah,
bored. Multi-talented, just picking up talents from anywhere.
Looking for something to do.
Yeah.
And you finally caught that on.
Yeah, and I felt like I would like rap better than poetry because I was already into music. So, yeah, I just took that and ran with it, pretty much.
And your type of sound, would you say is the same as somebody other that's rapping? Or you say your style is different? Or what would you say?
Me personally, I think I'm unique. Like, I try to set myself as a standout rapper and pretty much not try to sound like too many other artists because it'll bore you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, I try to keep a unique sound, but I heard a lot, like Lil Wayne, J. Cole, pretty much around now, but I mean, Wayne, one of my favorite rappers, so. Him and J. Cole, so yeah, I could, if I was to say any similarity, I'd say them.
Yeah. And would you say those are some of your favorite rappers? Or?
Yeah, J. Cole, Wayne, Drake, Meek Mill. I like Ross, Tupac, one of my all-time favorite. I like the old Kanye, man.
The old Kanye,
Kanye.
I hear that a lot.
Yeah, I fuck with the old Kanye. Most definitely.
Do you do any open mics when you did poetry or just go on stage in the time?
I ain't really too much open mic with poetry that much. Probably a couple times I went to some poetry nights. I really want to start doing more. Mm. Pretty much, yeah.
So you still doing poetry too?
Yeah. I still write poetry.
Right, cool. Yeah. Now, for the people, you wanna spit a little something for us? You know, wanna wait till after? But you know, now's the time. You might as well, you know.
Might as well.
Spit what, like some flow?
Hey, anything you got, me, bro. Right. Anything that'll get the people attention.
Any type of flow.
Spit, go on, spit a little something for us. It could be something you already wrote down, already made up. It could be something new that you was, you know, ready to show the people.
Well, definitely. Let me see what I got for y'all. I spend late nights like a slumber party, fighting my sleep like I'm Jeff Hardy. It's people that say they here, but I don't hear from them hardly. I got trust problems, man. A few people done scarred me. I'm a young spitter, young dope hitter. Work hard on the weekends, yeah. No scissor. Can't wait till the day that I rock. Coachella slept on, cold feather fly, then some eagle feather. Should I cry this time? Should I cry this time? Nah, I put tears on the line like way too many times. See my heart cries for anger and my soul stand strong and it still cries for help. When I'm feeling so alone and when I'm dealing with these problems, see, I stand by myself. I ain't tripping, gotta get it. I'ma rise for the belt. Yeah.
Oh yeah. For sure. And that was something you already, you know, came up with?
Yeah. That's a little flow off of my mixtape Get Ready.
Okay.
Yeah, off my mixtape Get Ready. That's on all platforms also.
And that's already out, right?
Yeah,
already. So when did you come out with that album?
At the end of January. Yeah.
And what inspired you to drop? What would you say the name of the album was?
Get Ready.
All right, and what inspired Get Ready?
Man, the name itself. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people been asleep. I've been rapping since 2011. I started taking it serious like 2013, 2014.
No.
I've been working hard ever since. I had some slow down years where I lacked off a little bit, but I just feel like it's just time to quit bullshit. You know, people been asleep, and I don't think too many people make it. Not even trying to sound cocky or nothing, but I don't think too many people just, you know, making music like I am no more. You know what I'm saying? Like, people don't really care for, you know, real music, real art, you know, real story, real meaning with music, you feel me? So, you know, I just want to bring back that wave, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just letting everybody know, get ready, you know, I'm finna wake them up.
And with everything you was going through, what made you want to start back rap?
The struggle.
Yeah.
Get my family out of the struggle. Just trying to, you know, I watched my mama struggle. It was 7 months, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I got 2 kids, so I don't even want to, you know, have them going through that.
So what made you different than out of the 7?
I say, I don't know. I guess my talents, you know, my siblings, they got talents. But I'm the one that just, you know, always picked up a talent. You know what I'm saying? So
are you the only artist in the family?
Yeah.
The only one that's making music?
Yeah, I had a big brother that wrote, 2 big brothers that wrote music, actually. So.
Okay.
Yeah. But I'm the one that actually decided to hop out and just take it serious. You know, invest my time, and yeah, that's pretty much.
So.
What do you like about being an artist?
That I can listen to my inner mind.
Yeah. You can express yourself.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, so.
I can actually sit back and play back my inner thoughts. So, that's pretty dope. And just touching people too. You know, relate, like, I write some music. I write some real struggle shit. I might be writing some real pain. And I could touch the next person that I ain't even know, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, many people can relate.
Yeah.
Like, many people can relate from your music, from that. Like, what they're going through, you going through, basically.
So you make more of a relatable type of sound. I say that because, you know, most people that's artists right now is just bitches, hoes, money. Shooting, killing, all that, you know what I'm saying? Like, you make something that the streets can really feel instead of just all that.
So, like, really, I wanna, cause I'm a street nigga myself, you feel me? So I'm better than the next nigga that came from that. I'm from Pritchard, Alabama.
So.
And I grew up on DIP, so I ain't better than the next nigga, you feel me? Yeah. But I feel like, it is, you know what I'm saying, it's more to the streets than just bitches and money and hoes, you know what I'm saying? So, like, I mean, I rap about money, I rap about women, you know what I'm saying? I do.
Oh, yeah, that's but everybody,
it's
but like,
than that.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Oh, so, and you said you was born in Pritchard and raised on DIP.
Yeah, I was raised in Pritchard too, also.
Yeah, so, and how was it growing up in them areas?
To be a honey, ain't too much different. You know what I'm saying? I mean, the only difference is the scenery. You know, Pritchard little rough. You know what I'm saying? Historical site. You know what I'm saying? You looking at houses that been sitting out 40 years before us. You feel me?
Yes,
and people actually living in them motherfuckers.
Mm-hmm.
You got some abandoned niggas trapping out of. You might find a dead body behind. And like. It's like that on DIP, but it's just the scenery a little different, you know, the people different.
Yeah.
You know, shit come out different, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like the difference between them is that Pritchard's a little more wilder, you know, and they got a little more feel when it comes to the city.
Yeah.
You know, they draw a little more feel to people, so you got people that ain't even gonna fucking drive through that.
Yeah, so that's one thing about Pritchard.
One thing about DIP motherfucker ain't trying to drive that far, so.
Yeah.
So that's it, you know.
It's
just shooting, killing, hoes, crackheads, dealers, OGs.
To some people, Pritchard at night is not the place to go.
Right. I mean, it's the same way on DIP.
Yeah.
You just gotta, you had to, you know, be there.
Know where you at, know what you going, yeah, know what you finna do.
And a lot of people don't know about DIP because they don't be there, but.
Yeah.
It's the trench.
Yeah.
It ain't nothing pretty about it, bro. It ain't nothing sweet about it.
Any record labels you looking to aim for? To do a deal with?
Nah. So when you get up, do you plan on keeping yourself a solo artist?
Yeah, I'm gonna be independent.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I would take a distribution deal any day, as long as it's good. You know, I'm all about my money.
For sure.
Yeah, so. But I ain't looking for no regular label, but if it's convenient and it's a good deal, yeah. I ain't signing or anything, you feel me? So, I ain't really too much looking for no regular label.
And outside of music, what do you do?
Yeah. I like sports.
Mm.
Basketball, man. I like playing basketball.
For sure.
I like going by the water. I just like freeing my mind. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I like to drink. Bye bye. I don't really too much club though. You know what I'm saying? Not down here anyways. But I play the drum set. But that ain't outside of music either. I mean, my life wrap around music, y'all. What I do, you know, I make my side hustles. I ain't gonna talk about it, but you know.
What stage do you go out and do your music sessions at?
Like, as in performances I done did?
Yeah.
Man, I just did a shout out to Dre, y'all. Dre Day. Shout out to Dre, man.
Yeah.
I just did a show with him. March the 15th, right before the city shut down. Right at the Mirror Well. Yeah.
Song for song.
Song for song.
Mm.
He has some good artists in there.
Shout out to India, she won it. And Titus, who was in the last round. There was some good acts in there though, you know, Japir. I like to do a song with her too also. But there was a lot of great artists in there, man. Zay the Great, Ocean. They did their thing though. Shout out to them, Rich. I did some shows though for Cleophas Smith Jr., CJ, CSJ, I don't know y'all ever heard of him, Company 28. But yeah, I did some shows for him, Bishop State. I done been out of town. And College Park, we did Georgia State Step Show.
Mm.
For the high school, we performed at that also. Yeah, man. I've been pretty much a lot of places all on the road.
Yeah.
I done recorded. The places I record at, Infrared. I don't know if y'all heard them. Infrared, Trevor. Infrared. Black Beans, and Ryan G.
Yeah.
What was the biggest problem you had to overcome so far?
Myself.
True.
You know what I'm saying? Like, myself. I feel like my biggest enemy is myself, y'all. Mm-hmm. I ain't never ever looked at another nigga as, you know what I'm saying, a problem. I ain't never looked at any situation, you know, I have to overcome is me. You feel me? It all comes down to me, so. The biggest thing I ever had to overcome in life is myself. Real shit.
And how would you say you cope with that? You dealt with that?
I'm still working. You know what I'm saying? I done got better than I was.
Mm.
So, yeah. You know what I'm saying? The better you get in life, the better your life is.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Better yourself.
Yeah. Sure. You gotta better yourself. You can't worry about nobody else. You can't better nobody else till you better yourself. Can't love nobody till you love yourself. So, it all starts with you, baby.
And with when you started rapping, was the negativity good? I mean, was the feedback good, or was there negativity? people were fucking with you? How
it was both.
Yeah.
And some of it, and the nigga, and I'm gonna say this, some of the negativity side that I'm giving here, the percentage that I'm giving here, had to do with fake love.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Cause the criticism that I was getting, I was looking at it like, that was the positive feedback.
Yeah.
So you can learn from it, basically?
Man, I know I suck. You feel me? I knew I sucked. I don't even come at me like that, man.
Yeah.
Don't tell me that shit was hard. Tell me what I need to work on. You feel me? That's the type of nigga I am.
So you push that out the way and better yourself?
Yeah. Yeah. So, like, I got a little both, but I just feel like the side that was positive was the people that was being real with me.
Mm.
The niggas that'll tell me, you know, that song, I actually like it. It could have been better if you did.
The negativity good, I mean, was the feedback good, or was there negativity of people fucking with you?
It was both.
Yeah.
And some of it, and the nigga, and I'm gonna say this, some of the negativity side that I'm giving here, the percentage that I'm giving here, had to do with fake love.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Cause the criticism that I was getting, I was looking at it like, that was the positive feedback.
No.
So you can learn from it, basically?
Man, I knew I sucked. You feel me? I knew I sucked. I don't even come at me like that, man.
Yeah.
Don't tell me that shit was hard. Tell me what I need to work on. You feel me? That's the type of nigga I am.
So you push that out the way and better yourself?
Yeah. Yeah. So, like, I got a little both, but I just feel like the side that was positive was the people that was being real with me.
Mm.
The niggas that'll tell me, you know, that song, I actually like it. It could have been better if you did this and did that.
Yeah.
Don't come at me and say,
oh, that hard,
shit
that
was hard at fuck, fool. Knowing that shit was weak, Hans, because I'm looking at this shit on Facebook every day. Yeah, some nines. I guess I can get y'all some nines. And I got an EP I'm dropping called Thankful and Blessed.
What are you dropping?
Thankful and Blessed.
To be announced on the date.
Okay.
Gotcha. I don't even know my damn self.
Gotcha.
But yeah, I got a mixtape. A Ball of Me is a mixtape. Actually, it was the first one I dropped in 4 years, 5 years. Six years.
Mm.
Shit, it's been 6 years. So this will be the first one in 6 years. My first Ball of Me is a mixtape, actually.
Okay.
I dropped the Ball of Me as an album in 15. Just to see how that go. I don't feel like I wanted to, but you know, we're gonna keep moving.
Get ready, just like the F.
Get ready.
All right.
What's up?
But get ready, I swear to God, get ready. I got a lot of big shit coming. That's all I can say. On that end. Yeah.
And before we get out of here, for the people that's not on you right now, that's watching this, wondering who you is, tell them what you got for them.
Oh, for the people out there that's looking at this, look, don't know who I am. I am T-Man, the top, the most slept on. But this is the wake up, all right? So, I got a lot of big shit coming with a lot of good artists. That might be one of y'all favorite artists out the city. You know what I'm saying? So, get ready. You know what I'm saying? More visuals in the works, some in the pop. You know what I'm saying? So, just be prepared, man. Just be prepared. I know y'all gonna fuck with me. Y'all just ain't on it yet. Y'all asleep. But this the wake up. Ball of Music, get ready, Thankful and Blessed, 2020. Oh yeah, and we throwing a block party. At Vibes, so.
Okay.
Going crazy.
That is to be announced also, but we finna hit y'all hard with that shit. Alright. Get that mixtape, get ready. Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, Amazon, Google, whatever, TikTok, Instagram Music, Facebook Music, YouTube. Also, I got Separate music video, official music video on YouTube. T-Man and Tyler, look that up. Also, Coach K, and they both off the mixtape, get ready. Like I said, man, download that shit, man. Y'all get with it, man. Get lost. That's all I got to say.